to perform user mass maintenance, you can use the transaction SU10. Using the transaction SU10, you can make modifications to user master records on a mass volume. So if you have a group of users that needs to be modified for a certain kind of information, certain kind of data, like for example, if you want to change a user group for a group of users, or if you want to assign a particular role to a group of users, or if you want to unassign a role from a group of users, or you can lock, if you want to lock a group of users or delete a group of users, you can use the transaction SU10. Now, let us go and lock, let's say, a group of users that we have. Let's say 2000, just use a 2000 till 3000. And enter the user ID there. Now you can enter the user IDs using copy paste mechanism, or you can use the address data or tag. We'll see how to do that. But once you have the user IDs, you can perform any kind of user administration activities on these user IDs. Now the only thing is, whatever action you take is applicable for each user ID in the list. For example, if I click on the lock icon, user IDs, all these user IDs will be locked. So let's go and click, let's select do that. So select, once the user IDs are logged, you get a log which will tell you what action you have taken. Now let's go and open up a session. Go to SU01 and check the state, log status of those user IDs. So go to SU01, go to test user 9000, you see the user ID is logged. If you go to test user, let's say 5000, the user ID is logged. Let's check for the status for, say, 8000, check the state, the log status, and it is logged. So as you see, using SU10, the action that you took was locking the user IDs, and that was applicable for all the user IDs in the list. So let's go and unlock this user IDs. And again, the log is generated. Now if you go back to SU01 and check for the user IDs log status, now this time it says not locked. Let's check some more. Not blocked. So using SU10, you can perform a common activity on a group of users. So you can delete a user ID if you want, you can group of user IDs if you want, lock a group of user IDs, unlock a group of user IDs. Similarly, you can, if you want to change information from the user master record for a group of user IDs, you can do that too. For example, if you want to change the user group for all these user IDs to, let's say, training, let's say, you can do that. So select the group and click on the change icon, because this is what is going to transfer the data into the user master, actual user master records. So similarly, if you want to specify the validity dates here, you can do that. So let's go and specify the validity dates as, let's say 999, and click on change. And let's click on save now. So you have 8 user IDs. So you have changed the user group and you have changed the validity date. So let's go to SU01 and randomly check some of those user IDs. So go to SU01, let's take the user ID change and look at the changes that you had made. They are reflected in the user master record. If you go to 6000, for example, this change should be reflected here too. So whatever you can do on one user ID in SU01, majority of such activities you can do in SU10. If you go to, let's say, SU10, you don't see copy icon, so you cannot copy user IDs using SU10. If you go to logon data tab, you don't see the password here, so you cannot reset password using SU10. You do not see a password icon here, so you cannot reset the password for a group of users using SU10. For that, you have to use SU01, and that you should be doing. You will have to do it one user ID at a time. But other than a couple of these things, like copying user IDs, renaming user IDs, or resetting passwords, except these three kinds of activities, rest of the activities like changing the user master records, deleting the IDs, locking, unlocking them. When I say change, again, you can assign roles to user IDs using SU10. Now, assigning roles to SU10, whatever roles you assign is applicable to the entire group. What it means is you cannot use, say, select 2000 and 3000 and say, I want to assign XYZ role to these two user IDs. Then for these two user IDs, I want to assign some other role. You can do that, but then you'll have to use SU10 that many times, depending on what the grouping is. So if let's say this is one group, so I'll have to use SU10 for this one group. Then if this is my another group, then have to use SU10 again for separately on this group. So now let's go and assign a role and see if that role gets assigned to these user IDs. So let's go and assign this test role to and assign to those people and see if it gets assigned. So enter the roles that you want to assign to the group of users, select the add radio button and click on save. So you'll get a mass change confirmation box, click on yes. And then let's go and check in SU01 for each of those users. Select this and see if that Y role has been assigned or not. It's there. Now let's go to some other user ID and confirm that. So let's go to 9000. Let's confirm if that role is there or not. It is there. Let's take another user ID, say 2000, and confirm whether that role is there or not. So it is there. Now, addition of the roles using SU10 is pretty simple. Go to SU10 and click on the change icon, go to the roles tab, enter the role name, select the tab, add radio button and click on save, and the role gets assigned. But removing the role from the user ID is not that simple. So you want to click, let's say you want to remove the role now, and click on save. Okay, let's cancel this process and redo it again. So let's cancel it. Oops. Okay, let's go and change the role and select this button. So removing the roles is not simple, like you can see. And to remove the roles from the mass volume of users or group of users, you also have to go and remove the profile of that particular role. So if you click on, so select the role, click on the remote app, remote radio button, then go to the profiles tab and select the profile, and then select the remove radio button and click on save. Now let us go and check the user IDs, if the user from, as the role has been removed from the from the user ID, so it has been removed. As you can see from this user ID, let's go and check for some other user ID and check if the role has been removed. So you don't see that Y role here, so the role has been removed. So to remove a role from a group of users in SU 10, you have to enter the role, enter the role name, select the remove radio button, then you have to go to the profiles tab also, and then select the remove radio button from the profiles tab and then save it, and only then the role will get removed from the user master records. So using SU 10, as you saw, you can perform user administration tasks on a group of users. The only thing in this thing in SU 10 is that that activity that you're performing has to be common for the entire group. Secondly, there are certain activities in user administration that you cannot do using SU 10. For example, in SU 10, you cannot reset passwords, you cannot copy user IDs, you cannot rename user IDs using SU 10. For all these three activities, you either create a cat script or you use SU01 to perform those tasks. So tasks that you cannot perform using SU10, for such tasks, you can create a cat script.